How do we know a cavity is full when insulating a wall? Let's talk about it. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to talk about a common question that we get, and that is, how do we know that the cavity is full when insulating an exterior wall? Well, first of all, let's talk about, you know, what makes up an exterior wall. Obviously, you know, most of us know we have studs that make up the framing of the outside wall, and we inject foam insulation in between those studs inside the stud cavity. Now, before we get too deep into this, I want you to go below and hit that like button for us. Thank you. Now, back to the topic. How do we know? Well, when we're insulating these walls, we like to drill our hole right next to the stud. Now, most of us may know that houses are designed with studs on center. They could be 16 inches on center, 18 inches on center, sometimes 24. However, anyone that's been in the trades will also know that that is almost never the case. There's always some type of cavity that for whatever reason had to be shorter or wider. And the other thing is there can be a lot of stops vertically. There can be a fire stop. There can be plumbing, an electrical conduit. There can be a ton of things inside these cavities. So how do we know that we're filling it all the way? Well, it takes a few steps. First of all, we use a Slim Jim. Every time we drill a hole, we put the Slim Jim inside the cavity all the way up, all the way down, and to the side. So what that does is it makes sure that the hose can get all the way to the top, all the way to the bottom, and that we feel for the next stud. This way, we know we're getting every single cavity. Sometimes they are, you know, 15, 16 inches apart. Sometimes they are 4 inches apart. You'd be very surprised. The other thing is, if there is that stop above or below, it lets us know we have to make another access hole, obviously, above or below that stop. So we use that tool, we use that Slim Jim to feel around to see how big that cavity is. The other thing is, again, when the foreman comes around and actually inserts the hose to inject the foam, he's doing the same thing. He's feeling, am I getting all the way to the bottom, all the way to the top, all the way to the side, all these things. And if there is any blockage, again, we make another access hole. How do you do this? You know, what are the tools? Again, the simplest tool that we use is just a Slim Jim. You want to feel for it. I would definitely recommend not trusting the electronic stud finders that you may use when you're hanging a picture or something on the inside of the house. I would not trust that in this application. You want to use something like a Slim Jim where you can physically feel when you're making contact with that stud. Don't trust the electronics. Yes, I'm sure some people have had amazing luck with it. Again, we have a lot of experience in this. I would not go that route. Use something you can actually feel. Which leads me into my last point, is experience and feel. There's a lot of muscle memory that comes into this. When you are feeling around different types of building structures, you do get a feel for it. You get a muscle memory that tells you, yes, that's a wire that I'm hitting, or no, that's a stud, or that's a pipe, that's an electrical conduit. You get a feel for those type of things, and that's the last point I want to recommend. Find a contractor who has a lot of experience doing this. Find someone who has done this many, many times before. I always recommend finding a specialty contractor whenever available. It's, you know, not to put any company down, but if there's a company that does, you know, 5, 6, 7 different trades, they have not put the time in to specialize themselves and gain the experience on each one of those categories. So if you find someone that just does insulation, just does foam insulation, again, they have that time in, they have that experience, they've developed that muscle memory for something like this, which is kind of a blind process, and it takes a lot of time to get that down. Hope this information was helpful to you. Please be sure to go below, check out the link in the description. We have an article that talks a little bit more in depth about this, how the wall cavity can work. Don't forget also, always leave us a comment. If you have a stud cavity, or if you know, you have a question about, you know, I opened up my walls and my studs are really weird, tell us about it. We'd love to talk to you. Also, always subscribe to this channel, share this video with all your friends, and don't forget to ring that bell so you see all of our notifications. Hey, don't forget, there's also a ton of information on our website, RetroFoamofMichigan.com. We have a learning center on there that is full of all kinds of information, articles, blogs, as well as videos. You're welcome.